Stranger Things, 10 Strange Things About the Show That Can't Be Forgotten. Ever since Stranger Things dropped on Netflix in October of 2016, fans from all over the world have gathered to follow the adventures of their favorite heroes. And now, with 25 episodes and 3 seasons, we sometimes can't help but forget a few nuances about the sci-fi show. In today's video, let's take a look at the 10 strange things about the Netflix original that can't be forgotten and sometimes don't add up. 10. Will should have died. Let's begin the list with one of the most important plot lines of season 1. Ever since the first episode of Stranger Things, this new sci-fi mystery series has been focused on the disappearance of the 12-year-old boy, Will Byers. Suddenly abducted and kidnapped by unexplainable forces and dark mysteries, Will found himself engulfed in a strange world. Known as the Upside Down, the younger Byers' brother began living in unimaginable circumstances. But apart from the creepy and terrifying surroundings, fans began wondering how the 12-year-old boy lived in the Upside Down. Without water or food, Will Byers should have died and not survived the harsh environment. But still, by some miracle or the other, Will returned home to Hawkins, Indiana, to his friends and family. 9. Will survived the Demogorgons. Here is another strange fact that didn't quite sit well with the diehard fans. If you remember season 1 of Stranger Things well, then you'll recall how two of the main characters became the victims of the Upside Down world. One was Will Byers, and the other was the fan favorite Barb. When their time of torture and misery came, the giant and core-shaking monsters, known as the Demogorgons, began treating these characters differently. What do we mean by then? When these terrifying monsters and creatures attack Barb and Will, they chose to eat Barb but only traumatize Will. Why did these bloodthirsty creatures feed on only one character? Was there an underlying reason or a secret that might be elaborated on in the future seasons? 8. Jim Hopper's reprimand. The selfless hero and the adoptive father of 11, Jim Hopper, is undeniably one of the most likable characters in all of Stranger Things. From him sacrificing himself in the series finale of season 3 to taking care of and looking after 11. But while Hopper may be a respectable character and figure in Hawkins, Indiana, there is one small detail from his past that we must mention. Even though Jim Hopper is considered to be one of the best police officers on the show, in season 1 he did beat up a fellow policeman. Without facing any charges, repercussions, or consequences, Hopper got off scot-free, just like that. Not only that, this violent incident has never been mentioned on the show ever since. 7. Hopper's detective work. Speaking of Eleven's adopted father, in season 1 of Stranger Things, we also saw the police officer try his best to uncover the murder of an innocent diner owner. While this may not have been such a big deal, considering his profession, fans couldn't help but question Hopper's all-in access. You see, it was actually the government that tried to cover up the murder. But why would the government give such high access to one police officer? How did Hopper manage to uncover a major chunk of this conspiracy? 6. Nancy's surprising skills. When it comes to talent and powers, Stranger Things is filled with interesting characters that proudly show off their skills. But apart from Eleven's telekinesis abilities and Steve's brave character, there is another major star of the show that stunned fans with her talent. Nancy Wheeler is the last person fans might have assumed would have no trouble controlling a gun or any type of weapon. But season after season, Nancy has proved to be a multifaceted character that has many sides to her. Even the actress, Natalia Dyer, couldn't help but swoon at her character's evolution. When speaking to Vogue magazine, the star shared, "Honestly, the scripts are great. I'm very excited. I'm excited for Nancy. Every time we end a season, we all think, where is this going to go? Where can this possibly go? Then we get the scripts for the next season and we're like, oh my god, wow, like, wow. So, while I can't say a lot, except that it's going to be a while before it comes out, it will definitely be worth it. It's going to be really big. It's going to be big." 5. Bob's death. One of the saddest moments in season 3 was when Joyce Byers' boyfriend, Bob Newby, was cruelly murdered and mauled by Demogorgons. Not only was the scene gruesome and terrifying, but the fact it was the likable Bob who died made this death 10 times worse. But just like the other storylines on our list, there is one part of this death that doesn't add up. And it's how Bob's death and murder were never covered up or talked up about in a major way. Instead of shining light on it on the news, Bob's death was sidetracked by the town of Hawkins, Indiana, which is unusual for the show to do, as most disappearances or murders have been heavily covered before. 4. Hawkins Lab. If a laboratory or a facility could be the bad guy of the show, it would definitely be the Hawkins Lab, the place where it all started. From conducting uber dangerous and risky experiments on test subjects to creating telekinetic heroes and mutants, Hawkins Lab is guilty of many things. One of those questionable things being their lack of security or emergency protocol. And here is what we mean by that. If a lab is experimenting on supernatural beings, they should have a plan B if things go south. But for some reason, this Hawkins Lab seems to fail to demonstrate a safe emergency protocol that could save dozens of lives. And this small detail is a huge reflection of the laboratory's poor planning and the lack of insight. 3. The Soviet Mall. Another confusing aspect of the show is how the Starcourt Mall of Hawkins, Indiana, supposedly serves a whole other purpose. But that's not the most shocking part. As it was uncovered in season 3 of Stranger Things, this seemingly innocent mall was actually just a cover-up for an underground lab. Said to be the base for a secret Soviet building, the Starcourt Mall's real purpose was discovered by the teenagers and the stars of the show. Which is why it's hard to believe that an important and secret laboratory would be so easily discoverable by young teens. 2. Hawkins' parents. Season 1 of Stranger Things revolved around the disappearance of Will Byers and the constant hunt from his mother Joyce Byers. It took only a couple of episodes for die-hard viewers to realize that Joyce Byers is one of the most dedicated and devoted parents on the show. But apart from Joyce, it seems as if mothers and fathers of Hawkins, Indiana, don't seem to be that bothered by the events or the stranger phenomena that take place on a regular basis. These parents just can't seem to realize the dangers and the disturbing plots their children might be facing. 1. Hopper couldn't survive the explosion. And the last strange fact we will be covering today is all about Jim Hopper's final moments and his selfless sacrifice in season 3. When it comes to jaw-dropping cliffhangers, Stranger Things knows how to shock its viewers and fans. And with the massive explosion that took place in the final episode, it's safe to say that this Netflix original series left us in a state of shock. But here is where this plotline gets a bit confusing. While many of us initially thought Hopper died instantly after facing the explosion, the trailer of season 4 showed the character alive and well. But how could this be? Well, even though the actual continuation of the explosion hasn't been exposed just yet, the creators of Stranger Things, the Duffer Brothers, did confirm that we would be seeing Jim Hopper back in season 4. It's not all good news for our American. He is imprisoned far from home in the snowy wasteland of Kamchatka, where he will face dangers both human and other. Meanwhile, back in the States, a new horror is beginning to surface, something long buried, something that connects everything. Season 4 is shaping up to be the biggest and most frightening season yet, and we cannot wait for everyone to see more. In the meantime, pray for the American. Just another questionable storyline we can't wait to uncover later on in the season. But what do you think? Will you be tuning in to see the new season of the Netflix series? What do you think happened to Jim Hopper? We would love to know your thoughts down in the comments below. Thank you for watching. If you liked our video, make sure you hit the like button below the video. And if you are new to our channel, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss out on our very exciting videos. Goodbye, everyone.